Supplement saga which haunted Essendon Football Club is now being called into question with new revelations about the drug involved. Today, Melbourne reporter Isabella Staszkowski has the story for us now. Isabella, what's happened?
Well, Deb, there's new revelations this morning that is putting this whole saga into question. Now, to put it in perspective, if you were an Essendon player who might have taken this substance, thymosin, back in early 2010, 2011, 2012, if you went on the ADSADA website in early 2013 and you looked it up to see whether it was on there, you would not have found it. And that's what's being questioned this morning. There's a lot of focus on the timing. Now, that drug was listed on the website just one day before the club put itself forward to the AFL. Now, to put it into perspective, let's take a look at this timeline. In 2013, February 4, the drug was banned on the website. Then, just one day later, the club put itself forward to the AFL. And on February 7, an official investigation was launched. Then, 3 years later, in 2016, 34 players were found guilty. Now, that was devastating for the club. James Hurd, of course, was booted from his role as coach. Joe Watson lost his Brownlow medal over the saga as well. Now, of course, the ADSADA says that this is something the club should have known. It says that the club could have contacted them and found out that this substance was in fact banned in 2010. But of course, this has been an ongoing saga for several years, so there certainly will be a lot of talk about this throughout the day, Deb.
Absolutely. Isabella with the latest. Thank you.
Now, updating breaking news out of South Australia, where a woman who'd been missing in bushland northeast of Adelaide for 3 days has been found alive and well. Nine's Natasha Kramer is following developments for us and joins us now. Natasha, Deborah Pilgrim was last seen on Sunday morning. She'd been camping with friends in the Sudan area. How was she found?
Well, Georgie, look, good morning. And amazingly, Deborah was found last night at around midnight. Now, it understood that a man remotely accessed his CCTV and saw an SOS in dirt on the driveway. Now, they were aware of the search, and last night they alerted police of this SOS message, and they went to search the property, commencing a new search in the area. She was found at a neighbouring home where she had access to water, and she's now being taken to a local hospital as precaution, but seems to be, surprisingly, in good health. Deborah did, as you say, go missing on Sunday. She was in the Sudan area for a party, a friend's 60th birthday, I believe, and multiple resources had been launched and a major search for her whereabouts. And on this fourth day of searching, they were planning to resume this morning, but surprisingly, yeah, she has been found safe and well, which I'm huge relief for her partner and her family and friends.
Yeah, there'd been big concerns about her safety, so that is a wonderful end result. Natasha, thank you.
The International Monetary Fund has drastically downgraded its forecast for Australia's economy, slashing its expectations of growth this year from 2.1% to just 1.7%. Now, that'd make our economic growth even weaker than that of Greece. The revision is in line with a broader slowdown, the international economy heading for its worst performance since the global financial crisis 10 years ago. Two people are dead after a stolen car smashed at high speed into an oncoming vehicle in Brisbane's north. Today, Queensland reporter Jessica Millwood joins us now. Jess, what have police told you?
Well, Tom, this is a tragic crash, one that has claimed the life of an innocent female driver. It was around midnight when this stolen car was heading north in the southbound lanes of the Gympie Arterial Road. That car has slammed head onto another vehicle, claiming the life of the single person inside, a female driver. Another person has also passed away, a passenger that was inside that stolen vehicle. The driver and another passenger, a third person inside that stolen car, are now in a critical condition in hospital. Police tell me that they tried to pull over the stolen vehicle in the CBD a little bit earlier in the evening.
There's significant damage to the front of both vehicles. Unfortunately, there is going to be an investigation that's going to go and delay traffic for a significant amount of time as well. And we're going to try and identify the reasons for the deception and not stopping for police.
Traffic continues to be heavily affected while the forensic crash unit investigate. The Gympie Arterial Road southbound lanes, so going into the city, remain closed, and traffic is being re-diverted down the Gateway Motorway. Right now, crews are continuing to clean up the scene. Detectives are here trying to determine exactly what happened and what led up to the events of this woman, this innocent driver, losing her life. Tom?
All right, Jess Millwood there, thank you.
Australian boxer Jeff Fenwick is already up and about after having open heart surgery in Thailand last week. A new photo of the 55-year-old has been posted online showing a large dressing on his chest. Fenwick has made significant progress but isn't out of the woods yet. He won't be able to return home to Sydney for about a fortnight. Prince Harry has become teary while speaking at an awards ceremony for children in London. The Duke became emotional as he spoke about becoming a father.
At an awards ceremony in London, Prince Harry tells the crowd how he felt at the same event last year.
Last year when my wife and I attended, we knew we were expecting our first child. No one else did at the time, but we did. And I remember...
An emotional moment recalling when he and Meghan found out they were becoming parents.
Now, I remember squeezing Meghan's hand so tight during the awards, and both of us were thinking what it would be like to be parents one day.
Halfway around the world, Kate and William are embracing local customs. The fashion-forward royals taking a traditional route. Dressed in emerald-coloured local garb, the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge arriving in style in a rickshaw to the country's capital monument. Earlier in the day, they visited a local school, speaking with teachers and shaking hands with students. One telling Prince William she and her classmates were big fans of his mother. Will and Kate also meeting Pakistan's President Imran Khan for lunch. Back at base, the Queen attended a service at Westminster Abbey with the Duchess of Cornwall to mark the 750th anniversary of the rebuilding of the church. Harry and Meg's also stepping out at the Well Child Awards in London to thank those who care for and support sick children. But it may have been the smallest royal stealing the spotlight with a trailer just released for a documentary on Harry and Meghan's trip to Africa, revealing behind-the-scenes moments of their recent tour full of baby bounces and kisses.